हेलो, हे वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वेलकम टू माय चैनल अगेन। हैव ए सेफ डे टू यू ऑल। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ ओजेनेसिस, डिटेल अबाउट ओजेनेसिस। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्क्राइब अबाउट द फॉलिकल्स, डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स, different cells associated with follicular formation, different type of ovarian follicles. So let's start the oogenesis and various events during oogenesis. The process of oogenesis is completely different from spermatogenesis. It starts immediately after formation of fetus. If we consider at the first month, that is at the fetal stage, there are about 1.5 to 2,000 primordial germ cells are formed. Primordial germ cells found in ovary. After 4th to 5th month, that means the embryo now converted into fetus. 4th to 5th month, the number of primordial follicle increases by the process of mitosis. It became 7 to 8 million. Oogonial cells are formed by the process of mitosis. After that, during 9th month, that is at the time of parturition, at 9th month, 2 million, and during parturition, the oogonial cells became primary oocyte. That means multiplication have taken place. Here, the oogonial cell grows into primary oocyte later. So, this primary oocyte formed during the 9th month remain as such till the appearance of menstrual cycle. That means up to 10 to 12 years, the 2 million follicles reduced again, 2 million follicle again reduced, and 60,000 to 80,000 primary oocytes are formed. Why? The primary oocyte never converted into secondary oocyte because the division sits here. The meiotic division at diplotin stage. Diplotin is blocked here. So, the meiosis became incomplete. The growth phase became complete. Primary oocytes are formed, but due to blockage of diplotin, no further process takes place. That means secondary oocytes are only formed during menstrual cycle. When menstrual cycle commenced, the primary oocyte became secondary oocyte. During the process of menstrual cycle, the primary oocytes are converted into secondary oocytes. It is the time period, that means up to puberty, that is during commencement of menstrual cycle at menarche, the primary oocytes exist. They are converted into secondary oocytes later on. like the process of spermatogenesis, the oogenesis is not very simple, rather it is complicated. It consists of three different phases: multiplication phase, followed by growth, followed by maturation phase. We have to discuss all these three phases in oogenesis. First of all, come to the process of multiplication. What happened during multiplication? Repeated mitosis takes place. At growth phase, the oogonial cell grows into primary oocyte. During maturation, the reduction division takes place. Come to the process of multiplication. This is multiplication. During the process of multiplication, what happened? The germinal cell divided by repeated mitosis. Due to the repeated mitosis process, the diploid cell, where the chromosome is represented by 2C, that means the DNA and chromosome is represented by 2N, the amount of DNA is represented by 2C. The cells are 2N, 2C states, 2N, 2C states. This germinal cell divide by repeated mitosis to produce new cells. These are called as oogonia or ovum mother cell. Oogonia, ovum mother cell. It is due to the influence of estrogen hormone. The gonadotropic hormone from pituitary induces the process of multiplication of germinal cell to produce ovum mother cell. Okay, the multiplication phase is followed by growth. In oogenesis, the growth is growth is called as grand period of growth, because it take a larger period in comparison to a longer period in comparison to spermatogenesis. During growth phase, the oogonia became larger and it is called as primary oocyte. This growth phase is again divided into two subphases: pre-vitellogenesis, and the second one is vitellogenesis. Vitellogenesis. During pre-vitellogenesis, the synthesis of cytoplasmic and nuclear material takes place. At vitellogenesis, synthesis of yolk takes place. Come to the process of pre. Then what happens at the process of pre-vitellogenesis? Here, during pre-vitellogenesis, there is an increase in nuclear material and nucleoplasm and nuclear material increases, the concentration increases, the volume of nucleic acid volume also increases. That means at growth phase, the condition 2N2C converted into 2N4C. What is this concept? This is the number of chromosome, it is DNA amount. the DNA amount became double, but chromosome remained constant as usual. Nucleic acid fall. DNA doubled, DNA became doubled. Lambros chromosome. The chromosome started developing side lobes, so Lambros chromosomes are formed. The growth phase in human, it takes place about 14 days. For complete growth, the human oogonia takes 14 days for converting it into oocyte. Okay, the size also increases during growth phase. The size of human oogonia from 0.002 mm, it became 0.14 mm. The size also increases. Okay, what happened then during pre-vitellogenesis? The other events are the mitochondria, cellular organelles increase, mostly ribosome and mitochondria. Another, the vesicles are formed. The vesicles are formed from the endoplasmic reticulum. After formation of vesicle, informosomes are formed. What are informosomes? The vesicles carrying mRNA are called as informosomes. It is all about the pre-vitellogenesis process. Then come to the process of vitellogenesis. During vitellogenesis, synthesis of yolk takes place. The yolk is synthesized in form of protein, phospholipid, carbohydrate, glycogen. It is synthesized in form of protein, phospholipid, glycogen as storage compound. First of all, this yolk is synthesized by another, except this nucleus, that is another yolk nucleus. How the yolk nucleus is formed? Clouds of mitochondria. This mitochondria cloud produces a yolk nucleus besides the original nucleus. This yolk nucleus, after synthesis inside the nucleus, it helps in synthesis of yolk. This soluble yolk is converted into insoluble form. Is it okay? Then the growth phase became complete. After growth phase, the oogonia became primary oocyte. After growth, the growth takes place in embryonic condition. That means when the fetus is present inside the body of mother, the growth phase have been completed. The growth never enter into maturation. That means primary oocyte never became secondary oocyte, because it is ceased at diploid stage of meiosis. Okay, then come to maturation phase. So after growth phase, primary oocyte formed completely. This primary oocyte is different than the usual diploid cell. The tensile strength of cytoplasm is more, because at this context, a number of proteins protect the cytoplasm. These proteins are called as pectin. This pectin help in providing a tensile strength to the cytoplasm. Rather than pectin, So in primary oocyte, they diploid nucleus yoke along with pectin. The pectin provide a tensile strength to the cytoplasm of primary oocyte. Okay, so the primary oocyte now enter into meiosis 1. At meiosis 1, due to higher tensile strength and yoke, the cytoplasm failed to divide. What happened then? The larger cell is formed, larger haploid cell, where cytoplasm yoke are present with a smaller body. The smaller haploid body is called as fast polar body. The polar body emerges when the tetrad come to the pole. In spite of releasing cytoplasm, the haploid sets of chromosome only released. Okay, it became secondary oocyte again entered into the process of second meiosis 2. The meiosis 2 is incomplete. Meiosis 2 produces ovum and second polar body. During this period, the first polar body divided, producing another two polar bodies. The polar bodies degenerated after formation because they do not have any type of cytoplasmic substance or yoke. So this second meiosis, this is the first meiosis, it is the second meiosis. Second meiosis has not completed it. The second meiosis in higher organ gene, the second meiosis is blocked at metaphase 2. That means at meiosis 2, the metaphase is blocked so that ovum cannot be produced. So in oogenesis, secondary oocytes are released when the ovum is formed. During the process of fertilization, when sperm come to fuse with it, the metaphase 2 proceeds, producing ovum and releasing the second polar body. Okay, it is all about the process of maturation. So the oogenesis completed. Please like, share and subscribe the channel for the forthcoming videos. Thank you all. Bye bye for next video again.